Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel RE World. In fact, welcome back to your channel RE World, powered by Team RE. We will be bringing to you unboxing and review of amazing gadgets, different application reviews, and a complete range of training session of Microsoft Office applications like Microsoft Excel, Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Outlook, and much more. From today, I'm going to start a series of Microsoft Excel training. Today's video will be an introduction of Microsoft Excel 2019, where you will learn the basic interface understanding of Microsoft Excel and its basic features. In the upcoming videos, you will learn the magical things which can be done with Microsoft Excel. Whether you are a student or you are working in an office, Microsoft Office is an application which is applicable in your daily life. In your office, you can do a lot of analytical works. At your home, you can do the budgeting, you can make your grocery list. My all videos related to Microsoft Office applications will be available in two different languages. You can watch the video in English as well as in Urdu. In order to play the English, you can follow the playlist Microsoft Office Trainings English, and for Urdu, you can go to the Urdu playlist. Okay, let's start the first video and see the basic introduction of Microsoft Office.
In order to open the Excel, you need to press Windows button from your keyboard or click Start, or you can directly search here Excel, click the icon. Okay, this is the first screen which you will see when you will open the Excel very first time. It has many built-in default workbooks which has different sort of information. We have Welcome to Excel tutorial, and there are multiple tutorials belongs to different functions of Excel like drop-down list, formulas, pivot tables, and pie charts. You can explore more templates by clicking here. It has different fields here, home, new, open, and few links here, account, feedback, and options. Let's click new. From new, you can open a new workbook. You can open any of the built-in default templates, or you can search from online Microsoft Office library for different templates. In order to open any existing workbook, you can click here and you can browse it either from the recent list, from OneDrive, or from your PC. It has account option where you can manage the privacy settings of your account. You can sign into your Microsoft account. This Microsoft Office suite has Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, OneNote, Publisher, Access, and Skype for Business. You may have the different icons here, as you will see only icons which license you have bought. Here I would like to emphasize that always use the original softwares and don't use any pirated version downloaded from internet. You may compromise on the security of your device, and that is illegal to use. So this office suite is having these applications, so it can be different the one which you have. You may have more, you may have less. You can check the updates regularly, and you can sign in your account so you can also save your data on OneDrive. Okay, let's start. Let's make a blank workbook. We always have files and folders available in our PC or laptop. For Excel, we call it workbook. So this workbook has name book 1. This is the default name. Every time when you open Microsoft Excel and you click the new, you will have book 1. So when we will save it with the new name will appear here. So let's try it. We can file, save as, this PC. I can go to desktop and I can save here RE World and save. So now this book 1 is renamed with RE World as our channel name. Microsoft Excel has a lot of features, a lot of magical things, and a lot of Microsoft Excel has a lot of features. There are a huge range of formulas, formattings, and you can use it in many ways. But before beginning and before going to the details, this first video is for the introduction about the Excel. So we will first understand the interface. What is the each part? How we can use it? It will help us a lot in the future videos. So you will understand more about the working and the operations. So in the future video, you will better understand Excel. Okay, this one we have title bar where we have the file name. We have here close, resize, minimize, and ribbon display options. We have here save button or icon and some disabled icons. I will explain later about it. These are the tabs. We have file where we can have different options like info. We can have the information about this workbook. What is the size? What is the title? What is the tags? We can save it. We can save as it. We can print, share, export, and many more. We have home tab, insert, draw, page layout, formulas, data, review, view, help, and this tell me bar. This bar is very useful. However, I will tell you later how to use it. This draw tab you may not find in your laptop or PC, or you may find it because I'm using a touch screen device. That's why this draw tab is there. So let's explore one by one. If you see in all tabs like home, insert, page layout, formula, there are dividers. Each these tabs are divided into further parts. Each divider is actually representing a set of settings, formattings, functions. For example, in home, the first one is cut, copy, format, printer, paste. The second one is about the font. You can bold, italic, underline. You can set the border, background color, font color. You can change the style of the font. You can resize the font by selecting the size or just by pressing the increase font and decrease font icons. This part belongs to alignment, where you can align the cell to left, center, right. You can change the direction of the font. You can wrap text, you can merge cell. This one is about the numbers, where you can set either general, numbers, currency, accounting, so multiple formattings. This is about the styles, about the cell alignments, addition, deletion, editing. Same with the insert. So each subsection, these are subsections. Each tab or section has subsections or divisions, and all these are named: clipboard, font, alignment, number, styles, cells. Same for every tab. So every portion has its own name. This whole we call it ribbon. This all area we call it ribbon. You can hide it, like auto hide the ribbon. Whenever you click here, it will come. You can click as show tab, so it will only show the tabs, and when you click, these ribbons will appear, and when you will click anywhere, this will disappear. And show tabs and commands will keep it remain visible always. So this is an ideal look. Sometimes we have to work on the large sheets and we don't need to see all these tabs, like if we are presenting a data in some meetings, or we are working where we need to see a lot of information same time on the window, so we just need to save this area as well. So you can simply hide it. This particular area is called formula bar. It is also having multiple use, but mainly it is called formula bar. We can expand it by clicking here, and we can also expand it by drag and stretch. This box is called name box. It shows the name of the cell. For example, this cell is F7. So F7 will appear here, but we can rename it with any other name. So it will show that name here instead of this F7. We can also call it, as for understanding, as address of the cell. This is the main area which is actually used to work. It has columns, it has rows. There are huge number of columns and huge number of rows, more than 1 million, and columns are more than 100,000s. In the later videos, I will show you that how you can count all the columns and how you can see all the rows. All the columns are named with alphabets and rows are named with numbers. If you click on a column, press Control button on your keyboard and click on any row. You see this column E and row 10 are interchanging on this cell. So if we'll click on this cell, it is E10. E10 means column E, row 10. Same here, column I, row 10. Or we can directly click here and write G15 and enter, and it will move to G15. In the future videos, you will see that sometime we also need this name box to use to move from one cell to another. Now this is the sheet 1. Here we are working, it is sheet 1. We may add sheets as much as we can or as much as we need based on our requirement. The sheets name are automatically incremental numbers from 1 to N. We can rename any sheet by right click, rename, and it will rename like this. You can rearrange the sheet sequence by simply click and drag anywhere. For example, Excel learning sheet, I want to bring it to the first. I can take it to the first. I want the sheet 5 and I want to rename it as backup, and I want to move it to number 2. So this is very easy. We can also select the colors for the quick identification of the sheets. Just an example that I have some backup data on one sheet which I need in different sheets. So I want to color this sheet as red. So I selected the red. So this sheet is easily now visible that this red sheet is for backup. And if I have multiple sheets, I don't need to read the name and I can directly immediately pick up the red color and I can work on it. In order to scroll up and down, we can use the scroll bar or we can simply go with the keyboard. For a horizontal scroll, we can go from this scroll bar. We can always reduce the size of the sheet as per our requirement, as per the data which we are showing there. So we can use this zoom area, which we can increase the size or decrease the size. This small area on the left side is very useful. It is called quick access toolbar. This quick access toolbar can be increased and decreased based on the icon you need. We can click here and add new options here, like new, open, save is already there. We can click on email, quick print or print preview. These both are almost same, so I'm just adding one. We can add spelling, undo and redo are already there. We can sort ascending, sort descending, and touch mouse mode. this touch mouse because I have a touch screen, so that's why this option is there. Moreover, we can also add more options here by clicking on more commands. We can select any of the popular, or we can go to all commands. If I want to add any other option there which I use more frequently, so it's easy to add there and it will be easy to use. So let's choose one. Let's say I'm going to add data validation. I will add it. Okay. So here, if I want to go to data validation, which maybe I am the one who is using very frequently, so every time I have to go to data, go to data validation and do the required settings. Rather than following all this path, wherever I am, on whichever tab I am, I will simply click here and I will use data validation from here. So it helped me to add a shortcut of a feature for which I don't need to explore the different tabs and need to find there. You can also change the position of these tools or options. Like data validation, I want it to be near open, so I will simply choose it to its position and I will click OK. And you see data validation, it moved from end to middle. I don't need this touch mode mouse button, so I am removing it here by clicking and disabling it. So this quick access toolbar is very useful, and I recommend the features and options which you mostly use, you must put a shortcut here. So you don't need to go to different tabs to search and find that option. Rather, you can select it from there. Now let's see one more useful option, that is, tell me what you want to do. Same like we have search options here in the start menu, and we can search any application or any software which is installed in our laptop or our PC. We can search here and we can open that software. So here it is the same feature but for the Microsoft Office applications functions. So here, let's say we were just talking about this data validation. If I write here data validation, you don't need to write completely. It will automatically bring the nearest close match. Click on data validation and you will see the feature. If I want to make it like name manager, you will find it here. I want to do auto sum and you will find it here. If I want to use VLOOKUP, so functions related to, because VLOOKUP is part of lookup and reference group of formulas, so we'll see I can find VLOOKUP here. Okay, or I can complete write VLOOKUP and it can directly open the formula argument table to add this formula. So this tab is this field is really very very useful in your day-to-day work.
So this was the first video of Excel. Hope you have learned a lot from this video. For my next videos, you will learn how to work with the formulas, what is data validation, what is conditional formatting, and there are many things to learn.
Hope you guys liked my video. Do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Please do like, comment and share.